गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, आई एम डॉक्टर सोनू, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फिजिकल मेडिसिन एंड रिहैबिलिटेशन, महात्मा गांधी मेडिकल कॉलेज, जयपुर। टुडे टॉपिक फॉर माय प्रेजेंटेशन इज ओरल रिहैबिलिटेशन फॉलोइंग ट्रीटमेंट फॉर ओरल कैंसर। या कॉस्मेटिक, फंक्शनल एंड साइकोसोशल रिजल्ट ऑफ ओरल कैंसर ट्रीटमेंट मे कंबाइन टू प्रोड्यूस डिवास्टेटिंग इफेक्ट ऑन पेशेंट्स, स्पेशली इफ द ट्यूमर इज एक्सटेंसिव और द ट्रीटमेंट पर्टिकुलरली एग्रेसिव। ओरल कैंसर इज नोटेड फॉर टोल इज एक्सर्ट ऑन पेशेंट्स फ्रॉम बोथ द डिजीज एंड इफेक्ट ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट। अ वैरायटी ऑफ फंक्शन में भी अफेक्टेड, इंक्लूडिंग स्पीच, डेग्लूटिशन, मैनेजमेंट ऑफ ओरल सिक्रीशन एंड मैस्टिकेशंस। ईच ईयर अप बिकॉज ऑफ कॉमन प्रैक्टिस ऑफ टोबैको च्यूइंग एंड अदर सब्सटेंसेज, प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ हेड एंड नेक कैंसर पेशेंट्स में रिक्वायर ट्रीटमेंट फॉर ओरल कैंसर। एंड मोस्ट ऑफ दीज पेशेंट विल बी रिहेबिलिटेटेड एट मेजर टीचिंग इंस्टीट्यूशन और डेजिग्नेटेड कैंसर सेंटर्स दैट इंक्लूड्स अ मल्टी डिसिप्लिनरी टीम। मल्टी डिसिप्लिनरी टीम मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग दैट विच कम अक्रॉस इन ड्यूरिंग दिस लेक्चर। परहैप्स हाफ ऑफ द पेशेंट विल बी ट्रीटेड विद डेफिनेटिव रेडिएशन विदाउट सर्जिकल इंटरवेंशन, बट दोज पेशेंट ऑल्सो रिक्वायर रिहेबिलिटेशन एंड फॉलोअप थ्रू आउट देयर लाइफ टाइम। दस मल्टीडिसिप्लिनरी टीम्स आर एसेंशियल फॉर हेड एंड नेक कैंसर पेशेंट्स, एस्पेशली एज देयर ट्रीटमेंट में रिजल्ट इन लॉस ऑफ ओरल फंक्शन इन कॉस्मेटिक डिफॉर्मिटीज। विद रिसेंट चेंजेस इन मॉडलिटीज ऑफ कैंसर ट्रीटमेंट एंड रिकंस्ट्रक्शन, रिहेबिलिटेशन ऑफ ओरल टिश्यू टेक्स अ न्यू डायमेंशन। द गोल ऑफ रिहेबिलिटेशन हाउएवर विल रिमेन द रिस्टोरेशन ऑफ ओरल फंक्शन एंड कॉस्मेसिस। Successful rehabilitation and quality of life and life go hand in hand because patient vary in attitude and adaptation. It is very difficult to predict patient's eventual quality of life prior to initiating treatment of oral cancer. Each patient is different, their expectations are different and treatment approach is different. So it is essential to understand what is the basic need of patient as per his age, as per his environment, as per his profession. The strategies and techniques of oral rehabilitation of a head and neck cancer patients are directly related to the location of cancer and to the extent and type of surgical intervention and radiation modalities used. Oral carcinomas not detected and evaluated in their early clinical stages usually evade contiguous structure, thereby setting the stage for extensive surgical procedure because they are not usually recognized at early stages. So in most of the cases we require extensive surgical intervention followed by radiation therapy. Removal of extensive segment of tongue, floor of mouth, mandible and hard and soft palate as well as regional lymph nodes, lymphatics usually mandate extensive rehabilitation management. An essential aspect of patient rehabilitation is oral rehabilitation, which must begin at the time of the initial cancer diagnosis with the aim of restoring and preventing continuity of anatomical structure, aesthetics and oral functions and contributing to patient psychological well-being and quality of life perception. Early or pre-rehabilitation is a major thing that generally not very frequently practiced, but it is very important to diagnose or start rehabilitation at an early stage so that patient will not face any difficulty or they have not major rehabilitation issue when they start their rehabilitation program. In order to achieve the best treatment outcome, a multidisciplinary approach to patient care is essential throughout the various stages of patient care. The term rehabilitation refers to the process aimed at enabling person with disability to achieve and maintain their optimal physical, sensory, intellectual, psychiatric and social functional level, thus providing them with the tools to adapt their life towards higher level of independence. Their optimal physical, their eating habits, their other working habits, sensory, intellectual, psychological and social functional level all needs to be assessed before starting treatment. Rehabilitation does not focus on prolongation of survival but rather on an improvement on patient quality of life. This is also the goal of palliation. The difference between rehabilitation and palliation can be found in the fact that rehabilitation attempt to re-establish impaired functions, while palliation focus on alleviation of symptoms. So in rehabilitation, we generally focus on recovery of functions to pre-surgical level, whereas in palliation, we generally focus on alleviation of symptoms. Interdisciplinary team involved in the cancer rehabilitation consists of first physician, rehabilitation nurse, physical therapist, occupational therapist, prosthetic or prosthetist and orthotist, nutritionist, speech therapist, psychologist, vocational counselor, social worker and recreational therapist. This generally constitute primary team for oral cancer rehabilitation. The rehabilitation takes place in various stages in different forms, such as preventive rehabilitation or pre-rehabilitation is started early after the diagnosis of cancer is made. Restorative rehabilitation therapy is directed at the comprehensive restoration of maximum function for the patient who have a residual physical impairment and disability. Supportive rehabilitation therapy attempts to increase the self-care skills and mobility of the cancer patients with physical exercises to prevent the effect of immobilization, such as impairment, muscle atrophy, weakness, and pressure sores. Last is palliative rehabilitation therapy aims at increase or maintain the comfort and function of patient with terminal cancer by improving their well-being, giving pain relief, avoiding joint impairment and pressure sore, and to provide at least partial self-sufficiency. So rehabilitation is started immediately after post-detection of disease and continue throughout the care. An important finding was the rehabilitation was underused in the population studies. Reasons for underuse may include the failure of the acute care staff to identify functional impairment, lack of appropriate referral for rehabilitation particularly in tertiary care setup, lack of awareness of rehabilitation services, that is quite common, and lack of knowledge among family members. These barriers can be overcome by providing education and by enlisting the cooperation of the clinical oncology staff whose background in the rehabilitation and functional issue may be limited or underemphasized. Of importance, all practitioners must keep in mind that the patient condition is stabilized and he or she may be discharged from the hospital. Rehabilitation services must be considered on an outpatient or home-based care. It doesn't stop after discharge from the hospital. It continued throughout the disease process. Patient diagnosis with oral cancer frequently have poor oral hygiene and dental care and comply poorly with treatment. Approximately 58 to 97% of patients require some form of dental care, with 68% of dentate patients requiring dental extraction primarily due to periodontal abscess. There is also a tendency for poor overall compliance with dental care irrespective of the socio-economic background of the patient. Unfortunately, the dentition is often forgotten in the initial stages of treatment, which may significantly complicate oral rehabilitation. After surgical procedure and during disease process also, there is a common tendency to develop submucosal fibrosis. Because of that, there is a difficult mouth opening. Dental care is very difficult. Patient develop frequent dental infection. For that, they require frequent dental extraction. But it is very difficult to remove dental extraction with submucosal fibrosis. For optimal post-treatment oral functional outcome, regardless of cancer therapy, comprehensive assessment of patient and oral status is critical to the patient overall care and quality of life. Following treatment for oral cancer, not many patients undertake oral rehabilitation, with only 5 to 25% patient requiring oral rehabilitation hour after treatment for oral cancer. Possible problems after surgery. Having surgery to the mouth and oropharynx may change how you chew and swallow. Difficulty in chewing and swallowing is present. Change how to breathe. because of decreased mouth opening and frequent infection and pain, changes the way you talk, difficulty in articulating or creating words, change your sense of smell, change your appearance. Some of these changes may happen because of your face is swollen and sore after surgery. These temperature will improve after swelling and pain generally subsided after some time after surgery, but some mucosal fibrosis generally progressive. Disease presentation, there are several symptoms and signs associated with head and neck cancer. The presenting complaint are dependent on location of the tumor. Few common symptoms are hoarseness, sore throat, stridor and dysphagia. Dysphonia, neck pain, ear pain or effusion, nasal or ear congestion, oral non-healing ulcer, mouth lesion that is white or red in color, cranial nerve palsy. The most common metastasis sites are bone, lung and liver. So most of the common problems following the oral cancer is treatment for oral cancer is basically localized to neck region or oral and neck region, but sometimes it may cause distant metastasis and distant symptoms also. Because of loss of oral intake, patient may develop weakness and over the period of time it develop into other diseases. Secondary or associated condition and complications are pain, lymphedema of neck, face and upper extremities, mucositis, xerostomia, trismus, osteoradionecrosis, dysphonia. Dysphagia, facial nerve palsy, quite common, other cranial nerve palsy, musculoskeletal neck and shoulder impairment including cervical dystonia, dropped head and neck extensor weakness, shoulder dysfunction and pain, scapular winging. Because of nerve injury, neuromuscular impairment including myopathy, radiculopathy, plexopathy and neuropathy, fatigue and radiation fibrosis. Radiation management and treatment, impairment and treatment overview. The aim of the treatment of head and neck cancer to maximize loco-regional control and survival while minimizing functional and cosmetic alteration. Surgery and radiation therapy aims to provide curative control while chemotherapy is used as a combined modality treatment. The role of rehabilitation is to reduce the different impairment which may include pain. There is high prevalence of pain in head and neck cancer patient before and after surgery, radiation and chemotherapy because of scarring and irritation of overlying or underlying nerves. Rehabilitation equipment to enhance function, oral or topical medication to decrease pain and spasm, injection for musculoskeletal pain or spasm such as anesthetic corticosteroid and botulinum toxin. In oral cancer, oral submucosal fibrosis, generally working with corticosteroid is just like working with the double-edged sword. It may cause infection, it may create infection also. So, Botox is generally preferable. But because of its cost, we generally, as per dependent on patient economical condition, we generally prefer either Botox or steroid. Difficult chewing, dysphagia, difficulty swallowing can occur pre-treatment or post-treatment with surgery, radiation and chemotherapy resulting in aspiration. Silent aspiration or poor nutritional status, one study demonstrated a prevalence of as high as 59%. Xerostomia, mucositis, impaired dentition, decreased sense of taste and trismus, reduced mouth opening because of poor oral hygiene and speech, nutrition and other aspect of swelling. Loss of voice commonly seen post-surgically in some patient. In some studies, 52% of patients were affected, but most of them generally recover over the period of time. Lymphedema, increased head, facial and extremity swelling occurs as a result of damage to the lymphatic system during treatment. Can treat with manual or drainage, massage or bandaging and compression garment, speech dysfunction, chemotherapy induced peripheral neuropathy. Neck and shoulder dysfunction and radial neck dissection may cause multiple structure involvement including muscle, nervous tissue and removal of bone tissue also. Neck and shoulder weakness and stiffness can be improved with physical therapy to lengthen muscle, regain lost length. And difficulty with ADL, 30% of patients in one study require assistance with everyday function, which can be treated with occupational therapy. Posture. As a result of treatment, pain and reduced range of motion can affect our posture. This can have a negative effect on swallowing. So, since patients with head and neck cancer have challenges with eating, it is very important to strengthen the neck muscle and make sure that any postural problem do not interfere with nutrition. Because of submucosal, there is a fibrosis ongoing treatment. Submucosal fibrosis, contracture of platysma, they can cause reduced mouth opening. So that can be lengthening or stretching generally started immediately post-surgery. Or it is started pre-surgery also. Fatigue is number one side effect complaint from treatment of cancer. Cancer survivors who have led very athletic life prior to the diagnosis and maintain some level of activity during treatment have been shown to have a better quality of life and report less fatigue. Coordination of care. A multidisciplinary team should manage each patient individually. Team members should include medical, surgical and radiation oncologist, cancer psychiatrist that we have already discussed. Monitored exercise is beneficial in treatment of cancer-related fatigue and should recommend it to head and neck cancer patients. Preoperative assessment of nutritional and functional status are beneficial in reducing post-operative disability. Preoperative assessment of cervical, oral and shoulder range of motion and education on exercise can help mitigate post-operative impairments. So, pre-operative or pre-rehabilitation is as important as surgery or post-rehabilitation. Physical therapy consists of several exercises like manual therapy and techniques to relax tissues, increase range of motion and decrease pain. Therapeutic exercises to improve strength in jaw, cervical, spine and shoulder, increase range of motion and improve posture, lymphedema management, lymphatic massage, exercises and patient education, and compression garments, technique to improve soft tissue mobility, full range of motion and communication in patient with TMJ, temporomandibular joint dysfunction, and pain management include electrical stimulation and gentle neck traction, and aquatic therapy in a heated pool to relax the tissues. Rehabilitation begins during surgery. When reconstruction is done, keeping in mind the functional and cosmetic effect as much as it possible. After the treatment is complete, the following aids are provided for further mobilization. Guide plane prosthesis. This is a clip-like prosthesis that is used after a lower jaw removal. By guiding the normal side of the jaw in its proper alignment with the upper jaw, it prevents the division of the mouth and help in chewing. It basically prevent if there is a unilateral lower jaw removal, it helps in maintain the position of alignment of upper jaw. It can be worn at a daytime, especially during chewing, or and can be taken off at bedtime or used for 6 to 8 months after completion of treatment. Jaw stretching exercises that we have already discussed. We can use a jaw stretching key or TheraBite tongue. This is an acrylic or synthetic tongue shaped prosthesis that can either be fixed either to the lower or upper jaw. The purpose is to enable the patient to be able to swallow and speak after removal of entire tongue or almost the entire tongue. The prosthesis work better for speech than for swallowing. The patient motivation is very important for best results. Then obturator with or without the teeth. Microvascular surgery is carried out to cover the hole, but if the hole is not very large, then it can be covered by synthetic plate, which not only helps in eating and speaking, but also improve facial contours. And that is role of obturator. Then communication and swelling, communication, swallowing and cognition. For patients suffering from issue related to communication and swallowing, speech, language, pathologists will help plan a therapy that may include technique to help patient produce speech more clearly, strategies to promote safe swallowing, exercise to increase range of motion and decrease pain, use of a splinting device to reduce pain and increase mobility, use of augmentative and alternative modes of communication such as electrolarynx, electronic devices or other aids, method to manage concern about memory or other technique skills. थैंक यू।